Hello viewers, I'm Dr. Meera Mishra. I'm working as an assistant professor in G.D. Goenka University. Today the topic of our discussion is how can community participation improve education? Education and community. Education is a vital instrument and a catalyst for social change and development. It is education through which we have nullified the various malpractices that was practiced in future past, and we have also developed new various milestones. It is the education which is helping us in the path of development and also in the path of enlightenment. Education has to benefit the common masses, ensuring equity and equality. It is critical that the communities plays a major role in it. Involvement of community by way of decentralized decision making will help in achieving the educational goals of education for all. Community participation. Community participation in education means the involvement of parents and community member in the planning and management of school that helps in the improvement of quality of education. That means when we are talking about community participation, we are looking for involvement of parents and community members at all levels, be it planning, be it management of schools, and because it is helping in the improvement of quality of education. Community participation can be studied with two forms. The first one is informal and the another one is formal. Informal, the informal manner in which the local communities can contribute to educational efforts are by providing a piece of land for the school building, by contributing labor and locally available material for its construction. Not only that, we have seen many instances where the local women who are good in cooking, they voluntarily donate their services for cooking the midday meal. Not only that, they serve, and sometimes the village other members, they also contribute the food material for midday meal. This types of example, they fall under the informal form of community participation. Here the community members are contributing to the educational effort through some informal way. Now the formal mechanism. The formal mechanism for community participation has taken the form what village panchayat and village education committees and ward education committees do. It is generally formal in nature as it involves following certain rules and regulations and the norms that has been set up by the state governments. So they act according to the norms and they take decision related following the rules and regulations as it has been stated by the policies and government acts. Now what is the significance of community participation in policy framework? National Policy of Education 1986 and the subsequent Plan of Action of 1992 showed consideration for a participatory approach in achieving the goal of education for all. That means the policy framework, the NP, is the most important policy framework in our education setup of our country. So here both NPE and Plan of Action has considered the participatory approach of community for achieving the goals of education for all or universalization of elementary education. The Right to Education Act of 2009, it calls for the constitution of school management committees by pooling in the participation of the teachers, elected representatives of the local authorities, parents or the guardians of the children who are admitted in the school and education and the local educationist. So this participation in the form of school management committee, school authorities and the parents and other village education committees are getting benefited as they get the platform to share and discuss the problems faced by both sides. The parents, they come up with their own concerns, and the school authorities also, they take up the concerns and they share their problems and their challenges in solving out or sorting out those concerns. At the same time, parents also love to represent and contribute their actively in the school, better learning process of their wards in the school. Now, the level of community participation are described. The level of degree of community participation as per Sheffer are involvement through mere use of services. Example, enrolling children in the school. So when we are enrolling our children in the school, it means we are involving through community participation, but only by mere usage of the services which is provided by the school. Involvement through contribution of money, materials or labors. Sometimes the members of the community, they contribute financial aids to the or materials or labor to the education process or the educational setups by donating land, by donating their labor and by donating some materials also for any of the infrastructure developments. Involvement through attendance, example, attending parents teacher meeting at the school. Sometimes parents, community members who comprises of members, few elected members of village education committees, few members of Panchayati Raj institutions, and along with the parents, they can take up some survey of the school and to see the hygiene condition of the school, to see the whether the school requires new classrooms, to see the pupil-teacher ratio that is being followed in the school, and also to keep a check on the performance of the teachers, whether the teachers are coming regularly in the rural areas or whether there is a problem of teacher absenteeism. The next one is involvement through consultation on a particular issue. Sometimes the school management authorities, they need consultation on some particular issues that they have been facing for long. In that case, the school authorities, they consult the elected representative or any member of the community who holds certain expertise on these issues, and they sit together and they solve the problem and they come out successfully. Participation in the delivery of the services, it is also important. Sometimes we have seen many parents who or any other community member who love to donate in their free time their services in the form of teaching to the underprivileged children without costing anything to the schools, giving some hobby classes to the schools, teaching them drawing, painting, singing, dancing, etc. Sometimes community members, they also take up the teaching of ICT or the information communication technology requirements, which is the need of the present hour. Then participation as implementers of delegated powers. Whatever the power has been delegated to the village education committees or other members, authorities like Panchayati Raj institutions, local authorities, they should be aware about their powers and they should deliver it accordingly. Sometimes the members of this power, they are also unaware of their roles and responsibility. So with the help of proper awareness and discussions, they should be made aware and they should be involved in the dissemination of the powers which is assigned to them. And lastly, the most important is real decision making at each and every stage. It includes identification of the problem that the community has been facing, the research, study of the feasibility and planning, implementation and evaluation. First of all, what is expected from the authorities that they should identify the problem which is existing in the, which is coming, which is hindering in achieving the goal of universalization of elementary education in the community, nearby community, and they should study the feasibility. Like if they adopt these measures, then what should be the feasibility, whether this solution is achievable or what kind of problems will be faced by the while going for this solution. Then if everything seems fine, then they have to plan, implement and evaluate. Then they will have to make decisions. Let us take example of extending the school which was primary to secondary. The first problem they will be that will be faced commonly by the local community will be the availability of the land. Somehow, if the land provision of land is provided to them, then financial aid, proper infrastructural material, these all provisions and granting of the aid, they all need to be studied. Then they will have to study whether the student enrollment ratio will be good enough, whether how to reach each and every house to bring, enroll and retain the students so that they can pass out from the school. Along with that, planning how the school authorities, school function will function in upcoming years. that will involve planning of the appointment of teachers, giving proper training to the teachers, provision of teaching learning materials, and various other factors, and whether they will see whether how implementation will be effective, and evaluation, they will evaluate the outcome of this decision that will be taken by them. So it community makes the role of community is to make decision at each and every step. Now, ways in which community can be involved: contributing in maintaining the limited resources. Sometimes the community have the provision of limited resources, so they should be equipped with skills so that they can utilize the limited resources in maximum possible way. Developing relevant curriculum and learning material to meet the local requirements, local need of the community, that adequate provision should be given in the curriculum. Provision of language and availability of the teaching learning materials should be taken due consideration, and community members can effectively help in this. Identifying and addressing educational problems such as low participation of the students, poor academic performance, etc. The community members, they can help in doing this, because they can move, they can from one home to another, and they can identify and address the education problem faced by the other community members. Why the students are not participating in this teaching learning process? Why the attendance of the student is low? Why the academic performance of the students are also not satisfactory? All these aspects can be studied and surveyed by the community members. Now, community members, we can strengthen the school and community partnership by minimizing discontinuities between school and community, parents and teachers. So it is very important for the school and the community to remain in direct contact with each other. Sometimes it may so happen that this community, after a few meetings, they don't get the proper time due to some other factors, and this discontinuity between the school and the community. So this should be avoided by the community participation. The adequate care should be taken to arrange events, meetings, so that the discontinuity between the school and the community should not take place. Increase the accountability of school to the society. The community members should from time to time make the school's authority aware about their accountability towards the society. They should always take into consideration the planning of the students, planning of the teaching learning process, everything. Advocating enrollment and education benefits. So it is the role of community members to identify the rate of enrollment. If the rate of enrollment is less, then proper educate campaign should be taken up by them, and they should make the people who are not aware about the educational facilities that has been provided in the nearby schools about the education benefits, and they should help those parents to get their child enrolled and avail the educational benefits. Most importantly is boosting morale of the school staff. Always criticism sometimes brings the morale of the school staff, it degrades that. So the community should always motivate the contribution of the teachers, the principals, in shaping the life of their students. Ensuring students' regular attendance and completion of the course of the school. Constructing, repairing and improving the school facility. Community members from time to time, they should contribute some kind of financial aid so that the schools should upgrade and repair the facilities. They should contribute in labor, material, land and fund. The community members can help in recruiting and supporting teachers in the teaching learning process. They should make adequate decision about the school locations and schedules. They should monitor and follow up on teacher attendance and performance. Why with the teacher attendance is a problem, then it should be taken and brought into the notice of by the community members to the higher authorities at district or state level, so that they should take the necessary action. Forming village education committees to manage school. The village education committees are elected, comprises of elected members, and their role is to manage the school by taking part in the school management committees. By actively attending school meetings to learn about the children's learning progress and classroom behavior. By providing skills, instructions and local cultural informations. Sometimes the school authorities are not aware of the skills that is executive to the particular community, and they are also not aware about the local culture. So it is the role of community members to apprise the school teachers, school authorities about the skills that is executive for in that particular locality, or and they should also make adequate provision that this local culture should be given due weightage in the curriculum. The community members can also help the children in with this studying. The members who are who have got the basic education, and they should take up the process of helping the children while they're studying after the school. They should garner more resource from and solving the problems through the education bureaucracy. They should, the community members can advocate and promote girls' education. In order to bridge the gender gap, the community members should make aware to those parents who are still not in favor of sending the girls to education. This is a harsh reality, still it exists in few areas of our country. Then they should provide security for teachers by preparing adequate housing for them. In rural areas, the proper housing adequate facility for teachers is a problem. So the community members, they can set up some measures and they can provide security, and they should set up a congenial environment so that the teacher should feel at home. And with this, the teacher will also feel motivated, and they should also take an extra step to help the children in the process, educational process. Then they should handle the budget to operate the schools. Whatever the financial budget of the school is, the community member should be apprised of it. By identifying the factors contributing to educational problems, low enrollment and high repetition and dropout, it is one more important factor eradication of which is possible with the help of community members only. It is community member who can bring into notice the problem that is being faced by the parents whose children are studying in the school. Why the enrollment rate is less? Why the students are not achieving, as a result of which they have to repeat the classes? And why? What is the reason for dropout? So these areas need to be discussed, and it should be brought into consideration by the representatives of the community through adequate meeting that will be arranged by the school management committees. Preparing children's readiness for schooling by providing them with adequate nutrition and stimuli for their cognitive development. Now, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan 2001, which was initiated in 2001, it's a step towards participatory approach, and it places high emphasis on involvement of all levels of community, be it Panchayati Raj institutions, village education committees, private players, NGOs and other grassroots level of management of elementary schools. The term village education committee has now been interchangeably used with SMCs in some areas, and SMC means school management committee, and school development management committee to denote the involvement of community in school management. So the SDMC, that is school development management committee, and SMCs are commonly interchangeable terms with VEC or village education committees. Now let us discuss some community participation examples. We all are aware about the Siksha Karmi project, which has motivated the community participation at larger scale. Siksha Karmi project was launched to address the issue of teacher absenteeism in the urban rural areas of Rajasthan, where the teacher absenteeism has taken a very bad shape. In that area, Siksha Karmis who were elected from the local communities, they addressed the need of the teacher, and they have set up an example which is followed by many other members of the society. So in the same manner, SS Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan has promoted the involvement of community in different states across the country, and awareness generation measures were also taken by the states in promoting education with involvement of the community. For example, in Rajasthan, along with the Siksha Karmi project and Lok Jumbish, a campaign on Mukhyamantri Siksha Sambal Maha Abhiyan was carried out to improve the academic and infrastructural status of education system. In the same manner, in other states such as Kerala, West Bengal, Delhi, Uttarakhand, the organized puppet shows, Rajasthan, street play, melas, etc. Apart from that, we all must have seen that few members of the society, they voluntarily offer their services in teaching the underprivileged or disadvantaged section of the society in their free time. This should be encouraged, and we should also contribute in our best capacity. The role of community remains central in improving the public education system, and it is critical to strengthen the capacities of the community and enhance the awareness level so that they are able to participate effectively in promoting education. Thus, in this unit, we have discussed the importance of education and the role of community in strengthening the school-community relationships. And we have also discussed how the community can contribute in teaching-learning process effectively. I hope you have benefited from the above discussions which we have done so far. Thank you.